focus on the issues in the American South. And he said no, because when lives are on the line, I cannot be silent.
Yes,
so I'm here today because I cannot be silent.
Thank you.
And the truth is, if you told me I grew up in Roxbury, if you told me even a few years ago that I would be here in West Roxbury as part of a demonstration, I might not have believed you.
Yes, Lord.
But the reality is that human lives and the future of our planet is on the line. And I cannot stay silent.
Right.
In the Black tradition, when we eulogize, we don't call it a funeral, we call it a home-going service. So tonight we are here because we want to lay to rest the economy of extraction and exploitation that not only is killing our planet, it's killing our people. I debated whether or not it's good to be here today, because all of these officers have to be here, and if I had my choice, I'd rather them be figuring out the sources of violence in our neighborhood and working to stop it. I'm sad because all of these workers have to be here today. And rather than installing more solar panels like that middle house, they're actually putting in something that makes our city less safe. But I'm here today because I believe we can lay to rest the spirit of exploitation and extraction that has brought us to such a terrible place. But the beautiful thing about homegoing services is that we celebrate life. So today I celebrate life. I celebrate the lives of all of you who are here. We are united across neighborhoods and region of this state, and even some of us I think are from other places in the country. We are united clergy across different traditions. We don't have the same exact doctrines or the same exact rituals, but together we believe that God and the Spirit call us to stand for justice, so we are doing that united this morning.
Amen. Yes, we are. Yes, we are.
I celebrate the life of the West Roxbury residents who have stood fast in the light, in the face of great injustice. I celebrate Mary, who has been faithful. She has been a watcher on the wall in this neighborhood. The scriptures say, I would rather be a doorkeeper in the house of my God than to dwell in the tents of wickedness. And she has been here, continuing to hold out, continuing to speak truth. Because this is not what we need, and this is not what we have to do. I celebrate that there is a different way if we choose to take a different path.
Yes.
Now, in the Black church tradition, we cannot have a service without an invitation. When I went to seminary, it was the first time I found out that people do not do an altar call at every single church. And even in our funerals, we often do an altar call. And so I want to make a call to you today. First and foremost, to those of us who are already here, I am so glad that we are here today. But we also need to go back home and talk with our family members, not to be afraid to knock on the door of our next door neighbor and share with them what is going on. I can't tell you how many people in Boston, people in my own church, who do not know this is happening. And we are only 2 miles away. If this thing explodes, it will rock the foundations of our house of worship. And everyone needs to know about it.
Yes.
The second thing is, this is an invitation to our brothers and sisters in blue. We recognize that you are doing your job, and we understand that. But we want you to know that we are also here so that your children will not go to the school at the Beethoven and have to do drills in the case of an explosion of this pipeline.
Yeah.
We are here because you live on the same planet with us. Because recently I saw a picture of what Boston's going to look like in 2060, and they told me we are going to have flooding every month at high tide. I live in Dorchester. not very far from Carson Beach. I didn't buy my house to live in a floodplain. And I know many of you probably live in the floodplain too. So just know that we are here in solidarity with you because you live in this city and we are trying to protect this city, not just for now, but for the future. And hopefully by then some of our children will be able to afford to live in this city because that's the price is going up higher and higher. We want you to have good jobs.
Yes.
And there are good jobs in this new economy.
Yes.
The same way that people right now are putting in a pipeline, they could be putting up solar panels, or they could be creating wind turbines that would save our city and save the planet. So there is no us versus them. Climate is an opportunity for us to let go of the old divisions of race and class and gender, and to work together for the kind of planet we all want to live on, and the kind of planet we would be proud to leave to our children.
That's right.
And so even now as we mourn, we celebrate life because we believe that all things are possible. I serve a mighty God, and I see the manifestation of God working right here, right